Mall is a dirty word. Well, that's what retail experts tell us. Shoppers today aren't looking for more than products. They want an experience as well.
So shopping center owners are pulling out all the stops. While internet retail is clearly booming, the flip side is that many shopping malls are going bust. In fact, 4 years from now, industry watchers predict 25% of today's shopping malls will have closed. You want proof of the demise? Check out Dead Mall Enthusiasts.
It is a website on Facebook for people all over the U.S. and beyond who want to document what's happening to their local shopping malls.
Ron Newman of Somerville contributes pictures to the group.
It can be depressing at times, but I just think the documentation is important.
Ron's posts include photos of Meadow Glen Mall, today an example of remalling. Its new design is outdoor storefronts, renamed Meadow Glen. Assembly Square Mall was also redeveloped with a downtown Main Street feel and a name change, Assembly Row. Has mall become a dirty word? We asked retail consultant Emily Eisenberg.
I think the word mall has a stigma because it sort of brings us back to there were Tiffany's and the Scott Baio's that were playing in the mall centers. They were kind of these cheesy places.
For other challenged malls, the solution is demalling. The former Atrium Mall is now a fitness center, and Arsenal Mall will reportedly be redesigned with hundreds of apartments and its new name, Arsenal Yards. But a larger question looms.
If I can buy everything in a click of a button through Amazon or any of these other online retailers, what's going to get me to go somewhere? It's got to be more than just a shopping experience.
So, to get people to show up, successful retail destinations have learned to offer additional life amenities, groceries, medical, entertainment, and events. In other words,
malls aren't just doing Santa Claus anymore. It's a much bigger expectation.
A good example of a complete remalling is Cambridge Side Galleria, located between Kendall Square and Cambridge Crossing. But note, the word Galleria is out.
Part of the whole thing was a new branding campaign. We changed the name to just Cambridge Side now.
And then they went on to change a whole lot more. Izzy Shate is VP of Property Management.
Every single surface was touched, every fixture, every light fixture is new. The floor's brand new, the escalators, elevators, everything was touched to create a much, much better environment.
Clearly, Cambridge Side has the advantage of urban foot traffic. It's surrounded by offices, hotels, and schools. The retail hall is essentially an extension of a city promenade, leading from Charles Park to Canal Park, where tour boats dock.
We do tables and chairs out here so people will get their food and come out and enjoy when the weather's nice. We've done concerts out here, we've done movies out here, and we do just a lot of events.
Including hosting multiple running events, a soapbox derby, and a variety of art exhibitions. All of this in an effort to get shoppers in-house to visit. For example, the new international fashion retailer, Superdry. World of Beer is in place in hopes of attracting after-work gatherings, and robust public Wi-Fi is now available throughout. All these improvements and attractions come down simply to this.
You need to give people a reason to get out and come shop in the center itself. If you don't change with it, then you're just not going to make it.
And they are coming up with plenty of reasons to get us to shop and ways to get us in.
They sure are. That is Chronicle for tonight. Thanks for joining us. I'm Shayna Seymour.
And I'm Anthony Everett. Have a good evening. See you back here tomorrow night.